Good morning and welcome to Sing John. Please stand if you are able.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The angel of the Lord said to Philip, "Get up and go toward the south to the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza. This is a wilderness road." So he got up and went. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of Candace, queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury. He had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. Then the Spirit said to Philip, "Go over to this chariot and join it." So Philip ran up to it and heard him reading the prophet Isaiah. He replied, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I unless someone guides me?" And he invited Philip to get in and sit beside him. Now the passage of the scripture that he was reading was this: "Like a sheep he was led to the slaughter, and like a lamb silent before its shearer, so he does not open his mouth. In his humiliation, justice was denied him. Who can describe his generation? For his life is taken away from the earth." The eunuch asked Philip, "About whom, may I ask you, does the prophet say this? About himself or about someone else?" Then Philip began to speak, and starting with the scripture, he proclaimed to him the good news about Jesus. As they were going along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, "Look, here is water. What is to prevent me from being baptized?" He commanded the chariot to stop, and both of them, Philip and the eunuch, went down into the water, and Philip baptized him. When they came up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away. The eunuch saw him no more, and went on his way rejoicing. But Philip found himself at Azotus, and as he was passing through the region, he proclaimed the good news to all the towns until he came to Caesarea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our song today is Psalm 22, verses 24 through 30, on page 612 in the Book of Common Prayer, or page 4 in the Worship Bulletin. That's Psalm 22, verses 24 through 30. We'll pray our psalm together in unison. My praise is of him in the great assembly. I will perform my vows in the presence of those who worship him. The poor shall eat and be satisfied, and those who seek the Lord shall praise him. May your heart live forever. All the ends of the earth shall remember and return to the Lord, and all the families of the nations shall bow before him. For kingship belongs to the Lord. He rules over the nations. To him alone all who sleep in the earth bow down in worship. All who go down to the dust fall before him. My soul shall live for him. My descendants shall serve him. They shall be known as the Lord's forever. They shall come and make known to a people yet unborn saving deeds that he has done."
A reading from the first letter of John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. And this is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is perfected in us. By this we know that we abide in him and he in us, because he has given us of his Spirit. And we have seen and do testify that the Father has sent his Son as the Savior of the world. God abides in those who confess that Jesus is the Son of God, and they abide in God. So we have known and believed the love that God has for us. God is love, and those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. Love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have boldness on the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, for fear has to do with punishment, and whoever fears has not reached perfection in love. We love because he first loved us. Those who say, "I love God," and hate their brothers or sisters are liars. For those who do not love a brother or sister whom they have seen cannot love God whom they have not seen. The commandment we have from him is this: those who love God must love their brothers and sisters also. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand as you are able.
Because apart from me, you can do nothing. Whoever does not abide in me is thrown away like a branch and withers. Such branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask for whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. My Father is glorified by this, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
grace and peace of God our Father, and the love of the Lord Jesus, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. One of my favorite movies of all time is It's a Wonderful Life. I imagine most, if not all of you, have seen it. And if you have not, shame on you. What have you been doing every Christmas? But it's filled with scenes of the life of George Bailey, and one of the kind of iconic montages before the great crisis in the movie is America's ushering into World War II. And George, of course, cannot go fight in World War II, so they talk about him fighting the Battle of Bedford Falls with scrap drives and rubber drives and all sorts of ways in which local communities were banding together to support those who are fighting abroad, including helping with the USO and selling war bonds and all those other things that people were doing at that time, stepping up, if you will. And certainly that's part of my imagination of that time, and that's part of the story we tell about ourselves. Every community had those who went off to fight in the war and those who stayed behind to do what they could to help and support. My own grandfather was awarded the Bronze Star and the Purple Heart. And so I heard stories all through my growing up about that time, such that it's stuck in my imagination. And I think it's true for many other communities that we reflect on that time as a time when the United States, our country, our people, banded together in support of one another. And even though it was a terrible, terrible war, there was something about the spirit of the people at that time that made it not only livable, but people look back on it with a certain fondness. Really struck that when this pandemic hit, we started to look back at the Spanish flu pandemic of 1918. And I forget exactly who it was, I think it was Ken Burns, the documentarian, who noted that the reason why we don't tell stories about that time and why there isn't much written in history other than the fact that it happened was that the United States did not do a terribly good job of coming together and supporting one another during that pandemic. And so that's not one of the stories that got passed on. And we really didn't look at it until we hit another pandemic and tried to learn from our past. It's important to recognize that the stories we tell and how we tell the stories shape who we are and how we understand ourselves. I think this is true of human families as well as communities. Think about your own family and the stories passed down from grandparents and great-grandparents and the stories you tell and the stories that will be told by your children and grandchildren about your generation and the things that you've done and seen and experienced. It's part of how we understand ourselves. And I'm struck by that as we're confronted with this image today of the vine and the branches, recognizing that we are all connected. And Jesus uses this powerful image, especially appropriate during this time of year, when so many of us are trimming hedges and weeding gardens and doing things to prune and get ready for the season. But that image of the connection of abiding and bearing much fruit is front and center in our Gospels. It reminds us that the stories we tell and how we understand ourselves and how we see ourselves connected is essential. It's the same theme in the epistle from John today, where he talks not so much about agriculture, but about a beloved community, where we cannot know God unless we love our brothers and sisters. And it's that image of being part of the vine or loving which captures our attention and our imagination during this Easter season. And it needs to be part of our story. Now, I've been a priest long enough to know that when I came to St. John's, I had to learn the stories. And so, those first years, I listened to stories about Father Lee and his wife Winona, the golden days of the parish, when we had so many kids in religious ed that we used the basement for Sunday school classes. Now those classrooms look like something out of a horror movie, but back then, apparently they were filled, and you still see kind of weird remnants of blackboards and other things behind cobwebs and musty smells. But it's those times which people talk about with excitement, when St. John's was bursting with life and potential. Now, there are other times in our history and other times of parish leadership and change that also have life, but it was really that golden time which reminds me of the World War II era of the United States, the Father Lee years of St. John's. And I'm certain they were wonderful. But they're part of our history, of our story, of our memory. And they're important parts of our story. But I think especially during this time, when we're living through a global pandemic, when we're at this time in the history of our United States, when at least to me it feels like we're more divided than ever, I wonder how the story of this time will be told. I wonder how our story will be passed down. And actually, that's not something any of us can know. That's for future people to understand and look back at this time. But I do think that this is a crucial moment for us. A crucial moment, sure, for the country and for the world, but also a crucial moment for us. Those of us gathered here at St. John's at this time in this place. Because the reality is that as the tide of the pandemic begins to recede, we have to reestablish ourselves. This is a new time for us. And I think we also have to recognize that over the last 30 years in our country, people have withdrawn from civic life in a way. We don't have people joining our civic organizations, our fire departments, and all the other ways in which people used to be more out in the community and community-minded. And that's certainly been also the case with our church. Most mainline Protestant denominations, as well as most other organizations, have seen their membership age and have seen their younger membership decline. But I would argue that it's not just the sociological factors, but also the factors of faith that affect us. For some reason, in this time, in this place, it has been harder for people to hear the gospel message, to feel connected. And in fact, I believe that this is the real spiritual sickness of our age. Terry Turkleton wrote a book called Alone Together, describing how at this time, because of our technology and because of the way we relate to one another, a lot of people are alone seeking connection. We've all seen it. People walking down the street together, yet both are on their phones. Or at a restaurant, the same image. We are, in a sense, divided and separate in ways that we have never been before. And so I would argue that we, at this time and in this place, need to hear this gospel anew. We need to recognize that we are grafted onto the vine. And that, as Jesus reminds us, apart from him we can do nothing, but with him we can bear much fruit. This is a time in which we are called to lean into our community and be more part of the beloved community than ever before, recognizing that our love for our brothers and sisters mirrors and gives evidence to our love from God. No more should people say about Christians that they talk a good game, but you don't see their love, you just see their judgment. No more should people talk about us as flawed people who simply sit in judgment of others but do not reflect the spirit of the gospel or the reality that the Holy Spirit is here. Each and every one of us need to take the place of Philip that we hear about in the Acts of the Apostles, who, when confronted with an Ethiopian eunuch, went out and shared with him the story of salvation so that he came to faith. This is not a time of retreat or sitting back. This is a time in which each and every one of us, here at St. John's, here in Marcellus, at this time and this place, need to hear the call and lean in. It is no longer a time for fear. True, we still have to be careful. As our highway signs remind us, COVID is still here. But just because the virus is still here doesn't mean that we are also, we are still here. And we cannot be ruled by the fear and withdraw from life. We are alive in a hurting world. And I believe now more than ever, we can give that hope and that love that is part of our faith to our community. We may not know how. We may not yet understand what God is calling us to as we begin to live in this new way. But that's not the important thing. If we are like Philip and hear the Spirit speaking to us, if we are grafted to the vine that is Christ, we will find the way. All we have to do is trust that God has a plan. God is in charge. We are not. And while we still celebrate this Easter mystery, that there is nothing that can separate us from the love of God that comes to us in Christ Jesus, not even death. And we must also recognize that even though times are sometimes confusing, it's how we understand ourselves. It's about the stories we tell. And it's about the way we live out those stories, which brings God's message of love, the beloved community, to our world in this time and in this place. And so together let us stand and profess our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed, found on page 6 in your worship bulletin or page 358 in the Book of Common Prayer. We believe in one God, the Father
and the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for the church and for the world. For the whole church in this Easter season, that we feel the enthusiasm of the first Christians spreading the good news, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who hold positions of authority, that they may help to transform our society and heal our fragile earth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those bound by sin or oppressed by evil, that they may find the forgiveness of sins and spiritual freedom as Easter joy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those newly baptized into the death and resurrection of Christ, that they may walk always with Christ in the newness of life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who are in need, for Maggie, Melissa, Tammy, Christine, Jeffrey, Christy, Tiffany, Alexa, Jack, Carmen, Nancy, Heather, Chris, Maureen, Allison, Jimmy, Kathy, Bill, Hudson, Tammy, or Tommy, Janet, Kathy, Matthew, Kathy, Edward, Jack, Griffin, Lucas, Melissa, Pam, Mary, Pat, Gary, Laura, Lee, Amy, Doug, Caden, Mike, Phyllis, Becky, Peter, Rita, and are there others? And for those who are sick or homebound, that they may feel the healing power and new hope of the risen Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who have died, that they may live forever with Christ in the glorious glory of the resurrection, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Your love for us, O God, surpasses our poor hearts. And your command is only this, that we should become true disciples by believing in Jesus and loving one another. Grafted now as living branches of Christ, the true vine, may we be pruned and cultivated by your care, and so glorify you by bearing much fruit in the midst of the church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Well, good morning and welcome to St. John's.
Good morning.
So we have our compline on Facebook Live and Zoom Monday through Thursday at 8 p.m. Father John will also have his Bible study on Tuesday at noontime on Zoom. I think that's all the announcements we have for this week. Do we have any birthdays? I know we have Lila Conley's birthday is on the 4th, right? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. She's not with us, but we'll send it over the airwaves and maybe she'll get zapped on. And for anyone else celebrating a birthday. O God, our times are in your hands. We pray, bless your servants as they begin another year. Fill them with your life and goodness, and may they know your blessings all the days of their life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
this continues on page 8 in the bulletin, or page 361 in the Book of Common Prayer. All things come of thee, O Lord.
And of thine own have we given thee.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right, a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father, Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Deeply we are bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death he has destroyed death, and by his rising to life again he has won for us everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Thank you.
for those at home who are unable to receive communion today. We pray that after spiritual communion taken from the prayer book for the armed services and found on page 11 in the worship bulletin. Communion, O Lord, with your faithful people at every altar in your church, for the Holy Eucharist is now being celebrated. I desire to offer to you praise and thanksgiving. I remember your death, Lord Christ. I proclaim your resurrection. I await your coming in glory. Since I cannot receive you today in the sacrament of your body and blood, I beseech you to come spiritually into my heart. Cleanse and strengthen me with your grace, Lord Jesus, and let me never be separated from you. May I live in you and you in me in this life and in the life to come. Amen. Our service continues on page 12 in the bulletin, or page 365 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray. Eternal God,
Heavenly Father,
you have graciously accepted us as the remembrance of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us down into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every work to do his will, working in you that which is pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Please stand as you are able.
My life on me, endless song of a great love, creation. I hear the real call of heaven.
Let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.
Oh.